新年伊始，美国通货膨胀指数下降，但经济衰退的隐患仍然存在。
2023年 GDP 和就业增长将有可能放缓。依据彭博社对大约40名经济学家进行的一项调查显示，今年经济下降的概率大约为7%。Wendy Edelberg 博士表示，经济增长放缓一部分是经济在复苏，家庭及企业支出已经恢复到疫情前的水平，但是劳动力的参与率还是远低于正常水平，大概有150到200万的劳工没有回到工作岗位中。
Under the rescue plan, the child tax credit was reformed and expanded in several significant ways. So prior to that, in the United States and today, under current law, this sounds upside down in a way because it is, but there are children and families who are deemed too poor to benefit from the child tax credit. So today that's about 19 million kids and families who do not qualify for the full child tax credit amount because their parents' incomes are too low.
在过去的一年中，新增工作岗位的速度是之前的三倍，但增长势头并不稳定。我们仍然在一个就业率下降的趋势中恢复，经济增长放缓会在一些领域有所体现，实体产业会比服务产业的增长更加虚弱。
I really believe in an economy that is people-centered. When families are doing well, when people are doing well, when workers are doing well, when we can afford to put food on the table for our kids and buy school supplies for our kids, you know, that is when our economy is doing well. That is I think there's almost I'll just stop there. So that is when our economy does well. So how do we get there? We're stuck in this system where the rich and very, very powerful corporations hold power and they hold wealth and they're able to shape the economy so that it benefits them. I think that became really, really clear over the course of the pandemic. We saw rampant profiteering. We're still seeing that, right? I mean, if anyone has gone to buy a dozen eggs in the grocery store, you have noticed that egg prices are up. And in fact, just today, I think a group of farmers sent a letter to the Federal Trade Commission to say, you know, this is actually profiteering. These are producers who are raising prices beyond what their production costs would justify.
2022年，美联储将利率提高了7次。并且在新的一年中仍然可能会继续。鲍威尔表示还没有感觉到提高利率的效果完全发挥出来，这可能让很多人体会到经济衰退。我们需要让所有人的情况都变得更好。有分析关注了过去一年失业率的增长情况，而美联储的预期是2023年增长 4.4%。 调控利率是美联储的主要手段，提升利率会导致借贷成本增加，使得就业率下降，工资增长下降。该手段主要针对于需求端，但通货膨胀并非来自于需求的增加，问题不是劳动力短缺，而是劳动力市场的标准较低，很多人并不愿意去做艰苦的工作。我们要提供更好的基础建设和休假系统来保证人们愿意去做某些工作。凤凰卫视田野洛杉矶报道。